Welcome back to the George S. D. Armanized Arena. This is Dan Craven with DJ Craven. Hey, not too long ago sitting in these chairs, DJ.
Yeah, the seat's still warm.
No kidding, right? I guess we want to talk about a little bit just quickly here. We got about 3 minutes, but first of all, we'll touch two things. You know, sort of a little disappointing on Monday. I think I heard the final shots on goal were like 51-19. Just summing it up real quick, Deej, your perspective.
Yeah, I think we kind of, you know, the shots just speak for itself. Only three goals with that many shots. The goalie played well. Couldn't get by a hot goaltender. I think that had a lot to do with it. Momentum early, down 2-0 right away off of our own power play. Didn't help things at this hole.
Well, the other thing I want to touch base on tonight, if you're looking at the Bulldogs warm-up, you're going to be missing number 16, the captain, Millen. Jeff Millen is suspended for tonight's game. He had five penalties on Monday night. And since this is we're playing in the United States, U.S. hockey rules dictate that he will be, five penalties. He's got to sit out this game. So the other rule, the other strange thing about it is, though, is that PIHL also carries that suspension. And since this is not a PIHL game, he'll have to sit out another game. So in essence, a one-game suspension turns into two for Captain Jeff Millen. Now, he will be able to play tomorrow against Crestwood. I believe tomorrow's game's at 3:45. So he'll be able to be in the lineup tomorrow, but you won't see him tonight. Deej, what losing your captain, what do you think?
Yeah, you know, it's definitely a unique situation losing your captain, nonetheless, but also in such a potential historic game here. Not ideal, but I tell you what, I think that the Bulldogs got to have a better message out of the gate here. And get things going right away and get some shots on early. A little too fancy, a little too late for the Bulldogs last time. So I think that has a lot. That's gonna be a lot to do with it. But yeah, losing the captain early is not good.
Looking to my right, I'm seeing number two on a jacket down there without a uniform on. I know we didn't see Ben Murray on Monday. We're not gonna see him again tonight. If my eyes are true to form, looks like he's in street clothes. He won't be on. Obviously, we just talked about Jeff Millen. He won't be on. Let's quickly talk about this Crestwood team, DJ. Team from Canada, not unfamiliar to Jamie Plunkett. I think that's his neck of the woods up in Old Canada, eh?
Yeah, they're from Peterborough, so they've got a decent team as far as what we know about them. They look like they got a lot more sides than Pearl here Monday night, so that's potentially could be something we want to look out for as far as how much they play the body. I'm not sure when they traveled in, but they did have a little bit more of a travel than most teams we typically see here at the Armit. So see if we can't capitalize. I would imagine they did travel today. So the legs might be a little slow, might be a little rusty. Again, right off the gate is where we want to start if you're the Bulldogs.
Right, there you go. Yeah, and you're looking, if you look at their buckets, you know their helmets are all different colors. So you're like, yeah, this is what they call secondary school?
SS, yeah.
SS, which is the same as our high school. So these are high school age kids, but you've got to wonder if the high school team is really the team that these guys play on, if they're not playing on some other type of travel team. We all know that a lot of the NHL comes out of Canada. You know, they've got different type of junior levels, you know, B, C, and D, and whatever else. But you wonder if they're playing both teams. So we'll wait and see. We'll do the best we can to keep up with their names. But I would suspect a little overall speedier team tonight than you did on Monday.
Absolutely.
All right, I think we're going to get ready here for the announcement, maybe of the starting lineups. We might get two national anthems. I'm not sure. We'll just wait and see how it pans out here. Your referees tonight are Mark Klimo, not an old familiar sight here to the Mark, Mike Vibro. Okay, I guess they're giving us the starting lineups. We can't hear that, but in any case, I think we're probably going to get some national anthem here. Oh, there's a starting lineup there now. Okay, so here we got Gizzy's going to be coming out. I'm going to guess we're going to see English and... Priscilla. Gizzy moved up on that line.
Somebody filling in for Millen there, I'd imagine.
Yeah. Well, actually, Franz is usually on that line, right? Isn't Franz usually with Priscilla?
Yeah, it looks like they split them up, at least initially here.
Yeah.
I'd imagine the scouting report isn't too great from Crestwood's side, so I got to imagine it's just a matter of filling in for Millen here at this point.
Okay, so, there we go. So I guess Franz might be jumping down to that next line. I don't know. We'll wait and see. Okay, it looks like we're going to have the national anthem here. You could have O Canada, maybe? No? Yes? No. Okay, no. So you know you got two Saudi referees. One hair's gray and the other one's baldy.
That's a good sign of experience.
So we know we got some type of an experience here. Okay, let's wait for the drop of the puck. Mark Kleinbaum again. Mike Vibro is going to be refereeing. Yeah, two good refs. These guys have been around for a while. They understand the game. They got the rules down. So this should be good. Now we got about six pucks laying behind the net behind Crestwood's goal. I guess their manager didn't make it today, Deej.
Either that or they're not real too tight on their rookies, that's for sure.
That's it. Maybe, yeah. You know, looking at their roster, they have three rookies. I guess, you know, 14-year-old guys. I mean, they're picking up pucks now. I don't know.
Yeah, if this roster's correct, I don't. They don't got nobody in the age of 15. I'm not sure what's going on there.
I'm not sure these little guys made it. I'm not sure that. I don't see 44, 11, and 14 out there. I'm thinking they didn't make the road trip. I think they just took a bunch of upperclassmen here. All right, we're getting ready for a drop of the puck. Everybody's circling their goalie in that traditional thing.
Yeah, another little tidbit. I think I believe, if it's correct, I think that the Bulldogs are hosting these kids. Is that correct? Did you hear that as well?
I think they're billowing them. You know, I think that, yeah, I think because they're going to be playing again tomorrow and then 3:45 and then back on the road. I'm not sure what the school schedule is up in Canada when they got to go back. But anyways, here we go. Bulldogs are going to be in our white sweaters moving right to left. We got Crestwood Mustangs, DJ, moving conveniently from left to right in their red sweaters. And here we go for the opening faceoff. This is going to be Pasilla, Gizzy, and Leach, I believe.
Yes, sir.
Yep. Puck back to the blue line. Middle ice going to dump it in deep. Go D to D. That's what Cooper Lagarde going to get it down the board, but not all the way deep. Puck's kind of loose. Gizzy's going to dump it deep and go and chase it himself. Going to be in there against some guy that's three times the size, but that's okay. Priscilla's going to take a shot. No, he's nice check there by the Crestwood defender. Wrist shot in there by Jacobs, just wide of the net. Priscilla behind the net. Wheel and Deal going to look. Pull to the point. Yes, he does. Cooper Lagarde going to take a slap shot. Hits the defenseman in front. Goes into the corner. Priscilla behind the net to Gizzy. Doesn't go. Priscilla with the puck again. Back around. Gizzy's looking to change. Priscilla's looking to cycle. All right, no problem here. Puck going to be breaking out of the zone. Going to be kept in. No. Someone breakaway here. Crestwood coming down. Nice check there. Put on the
Jacobs.
By Jacobs. Back comes a Bulldog. Little stick work there. Not sure what happened there. Nice back check there by Steiner.
Steiner, yes.
Made a nice back check. That kid would have had an opportunity, but Steiner comes back nice and tells him, nah, no way. This is a potential icing. Puck all the way down the other end. We do have icing. 13:52 on a stop clock. 0-0 here at the House of Chills. And I guess we're going to, I don't know if they have the no change rule. I guess they do in Canada, Dean.
Well, it's USA Hockey, right? So we're playing by our rules here.
By our rules here, yeah. So that's whatever that means. So face off just to the left of Kaufman. Puck shot on goal. Nice play there by the Crestwood guy to try to get a second shot on goal. That was number 91, Jake Heron. But I think that's Jacob, isn't it? Or Kaufman, isn't it? Yeah.
Yeah, oh yeah. He's their only one.
Oh, well, I hear you. Okay, now we're going to change. We're going to have Luke English out there with Triola and Franz. So there's a little bit of a shakeup due to the fact that Millen is, as we talked about earlier, suspended. So the lines aren't as they normally are.
Yeah, might take a little bit used to getting used to that, but I'm sure they practice at least once this week on it.
Oh no, that's 27. That's Greg over there.
Yeah, Greg Triola and English is in the middle of them.
There we go. So here we go. Puck's going to be trying to put in front of the net, block again by the defense. I'll tell you what, these guys are big, but we got some big guys as well. Puck in behind the Crestwood goal, circles all the way around. English can't get there. Poked in there by Triola. Kept the puck at circle high. That goes around all the way the other way. This is going to be Greg going to keep the puck deep again. English can get to it. Yes, no, yes. Going to put it in front. Triola lets it go. Slap shot there by Patassi. Right on goal. That's a nice play by the Bulldogs. You know, I think they got a little hops in their legs today.
Absolutely. We definitely have the upper hand here. The Mustangs seem to be a little tentative. I'm not sure, again, if that's a long bus ride, new rink, new area. I'm not sure, but definitely, hopefully, continue this up.
Yeah, for sure. Okay, that was what Chase, that's Weber on the draw there. Going to put the puck back to the point. This is Cooper Lagarde's shot, doesn't make it. Puck into the neutral zone. This is Jacobs, going to look to turn. He's got two Bulldogs on, or I'm sorry, two Mustangs on him, but able to keep the puck deep into the Mustang zone. Mustangs looking to break out. Poke check there nicely by Jacobs. Going to kept in by Franz. Wheel and deal, still has the puck. Going to look and go across the blue line. Take a wrist shot. Oh, just wide of the net. Beat the goalie, but just missed the net. Jacobs, nice job to get the puck to Franz. Franz, take a shot.
Oh, nice shot.
I'm telling you, another nice shot. I think he hit the pillows himself. I don't think the goalie saw it. Puck's going down the other end. This is going to be Cooper Lagarde turning near side boards. Put it up front. Nice play by Franz. Tip it over to Weber. Weber's going to get the line. Yes, he does. Going to take a shot. Bounce off the defenseman into the corner. This is Franz. Franz working hard against two defenders. Look to put in front. Here we go. This is Hoffman. Going to take a shot. Oh, bounced off about four people and almost went into the upper 90. Pasilla keep the puck in deep as Patassi. Going to go back into the corner. Far side. This is the Mustangs going to try to break out. I'll tell you, the breakout hasn't been the best, DJ.
No, they look at sloppy. That's what I mean. They're definitely very tentative. I don't know if that's how they are or that's just how they're starting the game here.
I got you. Okay, puck deep in the far corner. Is that Leach? Leach trying to keep the puck deep. Yes, he does. Uses his feet nicely. Puck's going to be shot all the way down the ice. This is going to be icing no matter what country you're from. We're going to have a face-off with 11:39 just to our left and also to the left of the goaltender. For Crestwood.
Yeah, I think, again, real good job here by the Bulldogs. I mean, three strong lines. Anytime you can keep the pressure in the majority of the time, you know, in the offensive zone is a good thing. How many guys they got down there, Dan?
Yeah, their bench?
Yeah.
They're looking about, can I say that? They're looking about 12. They got about 12 on the bench.
Okay.
So they traveled about 17, maybe. I don't know if that's an extra goalie or not. we're going to be offside on a delay. Vibrals all over it. Puck coming the other way. Oh, somebody blew an edge.
There's that knoll again.
Grassy knoll. We forgot to tell them there's snipers here. Here we go. Back the other way. Puck going to keep in deep by Hoffman. Hopefully that kid didn't walk from the bus.
Yes, really.
All right. Here we go. Back into the corner. Crestwood's going to try to break it out all the way. Far side board to the winger. He leaves it deep. Oh, we lose an edge.
There's another one.
Greg Lawson. I'm telling you, there's sand or something somewhere. It's a conspiracy. Back comes Crestwood, going to put it in front, can't connect. Then by the Zamboni doors.
Jacobs put somebody down again.
Jacobs is hitting people. That's a good thing. Fucking behind the Bulldog zone. Crestwood has it, going to put it in front. Nice save there. Where is it? Finally, Klimo calls her dead.
Coffin's got it. Good play there to get 70. He got back up after getting hit by Jacobs. Nice tip in front by, is that number 8? He's their... Carson Hartwick, he's their leading goal scorer from the stats. We do have 11 points, looks like, in roughly about 7 games.
Well, there you go. That answers that. I mean, nice play. That was a nice pass by that number 7 in front. Cooper Lagarde putting the puck all the way around. Greg can't corral it. They're going to keep it in nicely, put it in deep behind the Bulldog cage. Cooper Lagarde going to stop, turn. He has two guys on him. Good forechecking there by the Mustangs. Puck's loose. Where's it at? Cooper Lagarde puts it ahead. No, it won't go out. They're kept in nicely by the Mustang. Here goes a shot and score. You knew it was going to happen. It looked ugly. It was a puck loose there, and it just looked like it was going to happen.
Yeah, it's an unfortunate play there on the board. Shirillo tries to come down to help out Cooper Lagarde. Doesn't exactly work. Finds his way to the middle of the ice, and I believe that was number 4.
Yeah, you're right.
Jeff Milburn from the Mustangs had buried it upper 90. High blocker side.
Let's see if we can get the scoring. I know it was number 4 for sure. All right, face off at center ice. Here we go. Patassi going to get the puck and put it deep. This seems to be Meville's MO. Put it deep and see if we can go get it. We'll see if we get the scoring. Okay. So it was 4 from 7.
Yes.
So, okay, we'll get you that scoring here in a minute. Back to the play. Puck in behind the net. This is Franz. Going to wheel and deal. Can't get to the puck. Start to break out nicely here for the Mustangs. Going to get to center ice line. Can't keep it deep. Coach is yelling to keep it deep, but he didn't do it. Franz going to wheel and deal around this guy. Oh, I called it here. Look at this. I'm telling you. Boy, I'll tell you, if I can only win the lottery that much.
It's good play there to come by and throw the body on him, though.
No kidding. I knew he was going to wheel and deal on him. Here we go. Puck deep into the corner. After it is Leach, can't get to the puck. This is Weber. Nice job with his skate to get the puck off that guy's stick, but it just doesn't fall under the blade of his other stick. So here we go. It's Leach and Weber. Weber's looking to change. Here goes Crestwood going to try to put the puck out. Hoffman steps in nicely, intercepts the pass, puts it deep momentarily. Here goes Crestwood in behind the goal. Cody Pasella stepping up, makes a nice play to forecheck. This is Franz going to take a shot. Where is it? It's in the guy's ankle. Now a backhand shot. It's wide. Puck's wheeling deal. This is Priscilla. No, I'm sorry. That's Leach.
That's off.
Yeah, and that's off the Morang, so we couldn't get the puck into the goal. So we got 8:57 and left to go in the first period. 1-0. Scored by the Crestwood Mustangs. So it was a score by number 4, Jeff Milburn. I guess they go by ages because I'm looking at his roster and 4 is last and number 44 is first on the list. So good luck finding.
Yeah, it's not numerical. That's
no, it's a hunt and pick. So if I'm a little delayed, that's because I don't know. I don't know if numbers are different. Okay, here's another chance for Crestwood. Going to streak down the wing. Nice pass there by number 10. He's our captain, so you expect big things out of this guy. Working hard, trying to keep the puck deep into the Meadville corner. Fighting hard. Puck's going to come to the corner. No, it won't happen. Here we are in a near board. Priscilla's trying to get the puck out. This is Cooper Lagarde. Got the puck. Somebody on his back. Puck frees itself in the zone. 2-on-2 if we hurry. Here we go. This is Gizzy. Can't get the puck in. Gets a little heat at the red line. Puck does go deep. Can't get too far for Priscilla. Breaking out now come the Mustangs. Center of the red. Can't put it in. Nice play there by Greggs to knock the puck off the stick. Here we go. This is going to be English. English going to wheel and deal far corner. Going to go behind the net. Going to put it in front. Nice pass there.
Oh,
and
post.
Hit the goal post. Greggs hit the goal post. Nice pass there by English. The goal post was Big Ben struck one. There's another shot there. Bouncing the corner. Boy, I'll tell you what. This English guy's flying all over the place.
Yeah, he is. He's playing well. He played well last game, too.
Yes, he did. There's a puck. Here's another shot. Loose puck poked out of the zone. Boy, good pressure there by the Bulldogs. This is Kaufman going to leave it to Cooper Lagarde. Behind his own cage, set up, no. Decides to come all the way around. This is for Jacobs. Jacobs going to get the puck, going to leave it. Now he gets the puck again. Puck squirted in the neutral zone. Back the other goal, going to try to keep it deep. Puck deep, but not all the way down. Yes, it does. Jacobs going to get the puck. Going to leave it there for Lagarde, but Lagarde went, they zigged and he zagged. So here we go back the other way. This is Jacobs going to put the puck off the board. This is Steiner going to look to do something. Backhand the puck. Oh, just over Franz's stick. He's calling icing. Oh, it was just that close. Franz thinks he might have touched it. Klimo says, no, we're going to have an icing. The face-off to the right of goalie Edward Kaufman the fourth.
Yeah, that's right. Again, nice couple chances there. Obviously, last time there with Luke English, nice pass in front there to get it right off the post there, right?
Yeah, it hit the post.
But Greg.
Uh-oh, I'm not sure what's going on there, but there's commotion again. We had commotion on Monday.
A lot of commotion.
Puck all the way around. Puck kept in nice at the blue line there by the defenseman from Crestwood. Puck's put it the other zone, other side. Shot, where is it? High off the glass. Good thing it's made out of plexi. working in the corner. Nice tip there, just wide. I think Crestwood's getting their feet a little bit now. They get a little more confidence here, Deej.
Yeah, especially after that goal. Puck possession time.
It's funny how that goes. Yeah, you get some puck time is right. All right, here goes Weber, streaking down the left wing. Going to beat this guy? Maybe, yeah. Turned him around, but couldn't control the puck. Pucking behind the Crestwood net. Working hard there, Steiner. Franz gets a nice job. Forechecking, gets the puck off his stick. He still has a couple guys on it. He's stick-hailing back and forth he goes. In front, deflected off of Weber's skate. Here it is in the neutral zone. 2-on-2, no. Puck is going to bounce into the zone, back out it goes. This is Steiner. Can't get it around a defender. Puck all the way down. Uh-oh, bad. Could be a bad change here for the Bulldogs. Shot, nice save there by Kaufman. Nice hit there by Hoffman. I'll tell you what. Welcome to my house. That was a nice check. Okay, this is Priscilla going to put it in front. Can Jacobs hurry? Yeah, he gets it, puts it in front. Nice save. Shot on the ice, but the goalie was better, equal to the task. Puck way in behind, far side corner. This is Leach going to try to get to it. Yeah, puts the puck back in the corner for Gizzy. Gizzy can't hold it back here to Cooper Lagarde. Keep the puck in shot. Another nice save by the goalie. We're going to have to try to get some rebounds. Looks like this kid's picking up some rebounds, DJ.
Yeah, that was actually, I think, blocked in front by the defenseman. I mean, they're definitely getting in front of shots as well. A couple big bodies back there on defense for the Mustangs.
All right, here we go. Puck deep into the Bulldog zone. This is Cooper Lagarde going to put all the way around the Leach. Leach is going to try to tip it out. No, can't do it. This is Jacobs going to put it ahead of Priscilla. Turn, he's got two guys. Can he beat them both? Nice play there to get around. And we got people jumping on everybody. I'm not sure that last night, Monday. Oh, they do
call. Yeah, he got it.
Mark Klimo is going to call a penalty. I think it's a good penalty called as well. This is going to be on Crestwood, I believe. Number 20 is coming into the box.
Lawson Hill.
Okay, so number 20, Lawson Hill is going to go in 2 minutes for a trip. And I think it was the right call, DJ.
Yeah, I think so. I think what you were almost kind of alluding to, we could have almost had one even after that. I think he already had his hand up. But after Pasilla was on the ground, he almost got a couple shots to the head and elbow even at yet. But, yeah, I would agree. Good call. Let's see if the Bulldogs learn to try to keep the guys on front of them here in power play.
Yeah, really. That hasn't been their strong point. I hate to say, you know, you don't like to be critical, but it hasn't been their strong point. Pasilla going to win the draw. Can he get it out? No. Pucks. Shot down the ice. So we got 4:47 on the running clock, 1:54 to go on the Crestwood penalty. It just started. Here we are in the first period with Crestwood winning 1-0. Bulldogs on a power play. Here's a pass all the way over here to thank you, Pasilla. Back up Jacobs. Take a shot. Defenseman took it right in the bread basket and shot it down. They're closing down, DJ, right? When we get a shot from the point, their defensemen are just umbrellaing down low there.
Yeah, I mean they're standing to the task. I mean, again, they're standing right in front of their own goalie. So if we can get one by him, it's, you know, could be free pickets.
That's it. Here comes Franz. Can't get past the defense. Put it down the other end. Hit there by Hoffman. We got 1:16 to go on the penalty. We really haven't had any really good zone time. It'd be nice to get in there and try to set something up. Here we are. Here, this is Franz going to get the puck along the near side boards. Puck comes all the way back out. This is Cooper Lagarde going to go. I'm going to say go far side. Yes. This is Hoffman, puts it deep into the zone. It's going to roll all the way around. Here we are for Leach. Going to take a shot by Hoffman. Good rebound shot.
There
score.
It is.
Luke Triola. Power play goal. So it looks like Triola is going to get it. And I think Lagarde took the shot from the point. We'll see what they call here. I'm going to say it's going to be 25 from 9 at least. We'll see if we can find that.
Yeah, my apologies. There was a miscommunication on the bench over here for a line change, so I missed it.
That's okay. I think it's 25 from 9 in somebody. All right, here we are, tied 1-1, 3:40 to go at the power play goal.
Yeah, Cooper Lagarde with the assist.
That's it. Well, we caught it up here. So we got Triola from Lagarde, ties the game up at 1-1. 3:25 to go in the game. Here goes Greg, deep into the corner. Puck's got blocked off of the defense. Back the other way we go. Potassi going to get the puck. Going to go D to D. This is Hoffman. Hoffman's going to look. Piss up the middle. That's to...
Chance here.
Yeah. English almost one step a little slower. I thought maybe he might have had a chance. He could have had a one-on-one uncontested, but just a little bit too far in front of him. Luke Triola, a nice job to chip the puck in there. Nice job to get a goal, too. Here we go. Puck in behind the net. Put in front. Where is it? Triola again. Backhands the puck. Almost knocked that one in.
Yeah.
This is Greg. Greg in the near side board, half board, fighting hard. Jacob's going to take a shot. There's a chip.
Oh, that a great toe save by the goalie.
Yeah, I was going to say that was going to go all every which way but loose. That's Cooper Lagarde's shot. Never made it in. English is back checking hard. Just a heads up, Gizzy's going to try to run the guy off. I'm telling you, that Gizzy, it doesn't matter how big you are.
Yeah.
Jacobs wheeling deal, nicely moved. Shades of Crystal Tang here, moving in nice. Good job by Jacobs to keep the puck deep. Kid's got good wheels deep.
Yeah, good hands too. I mean, he's got a good head for good head up with it, with the puck. He's definitely moving well. Oh, good pick there by Vibes.
Not good. All right. Puck's going all the way down. We're going to have icing. Okay, with 2 minutes and 1 second to go, Canada time, U.S. time, 1-1 Bulldogs.
Much better on the power play there, right? So we got one score for the good guys.
Oh, baby, write that down. In fact, I got my highlighter right here. I'm highlighting the PP on my score sheet.
Well, like you said, we finally got some puck time in the offensive zone there and were able to set up shop and Trillo. What, did he just drag it right out front?
Yeah, he did. Okay, here we go. Crestwood's going to put the puck D to D behind their own net. Oh, the guy can't keep a hold of it. Shot didn't make it to the goal. Here they go. They're going to try to break out again. Here we go. 3-on-2 if they hurry. Back into the defensive zone they go. Shot wide. Uh-oh. Not a rebound there. Kaufman equal to the task. That was kind of a weird bounce, but I'll tell you what. Ed Kaufman is being able to keep an eye on things.
Yeah, Eddie did a great job there. I mean, like you said, that was kind of a weird bounce, but he stayed with it. I mean, that guy had nowhere to go there.
All right, here we go. Here we go. Just under 2 minutes to go. We got a face off in our zone, just left of the goaltender, Eddie Kaufman. Looks like we have Weber. And then there's Potassio on this side. Who we got? Franz. And we got Hoffman. And then there looks like Steiner.
Steiner, yeah.
Who am I missing?
What's that?
I'm missing somebody, aren't I?
No, you got three there. Oh, Potassio's over here on D.
All right, got him too. All right, missed him. My fault. You know, that modern technology, you just can't get a good. There we go. Out comes Cody Pasilla. They're looking to win a draw. Weber's a little upset with himself. He's a young kid, right? Going against this guy, the captain. You wouldn't expect him to be winning all kind of draws. That's why we got Pasilla here. Big draw to win. See what happens here.
Shows Chiefs experience, too, as well.
Yeah, this is going to be a break. If Steiner could have got by him, we would have been going to set Franz free, but he didn't make it. Franz in on a goal. Nice play there by the defense just to keep Franz just off his edge, no pun intended, DJ. Just off his edge.
Yeah, absolutely. Again, you know, just a veteran move there behind the bench. Weber's back out there for the offensive zone, but, you know, you lose one. Let's go ahead and let's get him back out there. Quick draw. Basilla's off right when they exited the zone.
I'm going to segue here a little bit, get away from the game, just get you guys watching here. But, you know, just to kind of what's going on, pretty decent crowd for this time in the time of day.
Yeah, absolutely. It's not just 5 o'clock now. Good shot there by Weber. Good, just 5 o'clock now. Yeah, there's a decent crowd all the way around. I mean, you see a lot of again friendly faces coming right out of the work hour.
Good stuff. Yeah, good deal. Good job by Weber to back check. The puck hit the roof. Yeah, they got a good call. Yeah, there we go. That was a good job by Weber to get back there. That potentially three on two turned into a 3-on-2.5 because he was back checking. We got 1:04 to go. Faceoff's going to be outside the zone. Apparently, one of the Crestwood Mustangs touched the puck before it hit the ceiling, and we had a faceoff outside. This is going to be Greg. Can't get the puck. Nice job there by number 10, but Greg's returned the favor. Puck in the zone. Here comes Triola going to wheel and deal. He's got Greg with him, and we got Inglis breaking for the net. Inglis with a pass. Oh, can't hold it on. He would have had a shot. He was looking to backhand it. Puck's going to come to the neutral zone. This is going to be Cooper Lagarde. Puts the puck in deep, no icing. Puck deep into the corner, going D to D. This is Triola going to get to it first. Big, strong Triola put the puck in front, nobody there. Greg's going to hustle over here to get the puck working strong. Here we go. This is Inglis back to the point to Jacobs. Jacobs with a wrist shot. Where to go? Bouncing around. Breakout, here we go. Nice play by Jacobs. Another nice job there to put the body on. Nice pass there. Good look by Triola. Nice job. They set Cooper Lagarde in. Nicely done. Good look.
Yeah, good patience there in the middle of the zone for the senior.
No kidding. Here we're going to give and go. Give and go. Who called it right up here? You heard it here first, people. Here we go. Here's Pasilla. Going to try to wheel and deal. Got a couple guys on him. Nicely done. Nicely done. Stick handling. The puck is going to be blown dead because you know why, DJ?
I think time ran out.
It's the end of the period. With the end of the period, we'll get you the shots on goal. Right now, the score is 1-1. In favor of nobody. We got a first goal to start off by Crestview. They scored on a nice play. Pass off the half boards. Big fellow top of the circle just fired it by. I'm not sure Kaufman had a chance. And then Meadville had a power play goal. I didn't get the time, but I guess I should have. I didn't write it down. But that was basically Triola from Cooper Lagarde to tie it up.
Yeah, I'd say there was probably right around that 4 minute mark ish, is what I would say.
Thank you. Okay, we got the shots on goal from the scorekeeper down below. It was even, 7-7. Seven for Crestwood. Seven for Meadville.
11.
Oh, for who, Meadville? Oh, I'm sorry.
Let's try that again.
My fault. There's too much music going on. I'm sorry. Crestwood had 7. Meadville had 11. Now, there should be a rule. You should not have rhyming numbers that aren't the same when there's music playing. All right. Excuse me. So we're going to change direction. Meadville's still in the white sweaters. They're moving left to right. Crestwood is moving right to left. All right. Here we go. This is Jacobs. Going to get the puck. Going to put it up ahead. Gizzy's going to put it deep. Nicely done. That's the MO here. Keep it deep and go chase it. Here's Pasilla behind the net. Going to give it there to
Leach.
Yeah, here we go. Back the other way. This is a point Lagarde. Lagarde's going to shoot it down. Back to their defense. Ken Controut. Nice job there. Forechecking. Cooper Lagarde takes a shot. Where is it? Good rebound. This is what we're talking about. Nice job by Leeds. tried to kick the puck to his stick from his skate, but it just bounced a little bit too much. He couldn't get to it. That's Lagarde going to put it over to Jacobs. Jacobs wheeling deal, going to put it ahead to Gizzy. Gizzy can't control. Good fighting there.
Stepped on the puck.
Oh, good. I'm glad it wasn't a trip. Here we go. Crestwood going to come deep. Yeah, they're going to play deep. Coffin decides going to catch it. He's going to put it down. Can't find it out of his trapper. Lagarde gets it. Puts it all the way around. Kept in there nicely on the far side. Put back into the center zone. Put back deep. Coming out. Priscilla tried to get the puck past the defenseman. Then got it back again. Max Wielandiel take a shot.
Ooh.
Shot it wide. Might have had him if it was on net. It looks like it just went over his catching mitt there.
Yeah, good job to use the defenseman as a screen.
Right. Yeah, Hoffman didn't get all that one, that's for sure. But that's okay. Here we go. Back the other way. This is Crestwood going to try to keep it deep. No, they're stymied at the red line. Or, I'm sorry, at the blue line. D-D-D back in front. We got an offside. We got a whole change in commotion going on down here.
Good back check there by Luke English. I mean, the kid's got a lot of jump. There's no doubt about that. You mentioned earlier in the first period, he's still got it here now.
Yes, he does. Yeah, the kid's got a lot of wheel.
Well, you know, there was a lot on Monday. It was in and out of the box, in and out of the box. I'm not sure how much he factors into some of those power play penalty kills. You know, he might have a little fresher legs than Monday from some of these other guys.
Yeah, good point. Pucking behind the Bulldog zone. This is Hoffman going to try to put it up. Blocked there by one of the Mustangs. Puck in behind the zone, behind the net, brought all the way around, can't get out, kept in there by the defense. Houdini on the ice, puck disappeared. Oh, there it is, came out of the coach's pocket. It just disappeared. I'm looking at the puck, it's gone. All right, here we go. Magic puck, DJ. I like to buy some of those. Weber gonna take a face-off here. Watch the face-off, here we go. Back and forth, D to D. Keep the puck in deep. Is it icing? Yes, it is. Missed the stick. And the puck went all the way down, so we're going to have an icing. Back we go. We're going to have a face-off to the left of the goalie for the Mustang. Weber's still out there. Who's going to take the draw? That's the question. He has been taking the draw. He's on there with Franz and Steiner. Puck drop back. Here we go. Going to take a shot there by Hoffman. Made it to the goal, but it was saved by the goalie. A lot of contact going on down there by the Zamboni door.
Hoffman sat somebody down again.
Okay. Nice play here. Oh, good back check and good everything there. It was good back check, good defense, and I'll tell you what, Coffin was paying attention. He worried about one thing. That was the puck. He didn't care about anything else. Reached down to pick up a puck. Nice job for, a young guy. I think he's like freshman, sophomore. He's pretty young, I think.
Yeah, I believe so. I believe you are right. I think he's a sophomore. He played last year, I believe, his freshman year, and he's our one and only at this point.
Yeah.
Can't have him go down. Somebody else will be suiting up.
No, yeah. I'm thinking that's what his class is. Okay, puck here to the blue line. Brought in nicely. Back the other way. Here we are. Mustang breaking in 3-on-3. Shot over Coffin's head. Puck in behind on the far side there. Trying to bring it out. Bulldog can't break it out. Puck's kept in deep. Nice play there by Cooper Lagarde. Still can't get the puck out. Nice shot there. Coffin found that in traffic. I don't know how he did.
Yeah, he fought that one off. Almost kind of handcuffed him a little bit.
Yeah, it did. That was a nice shot by the defender. He had a bunch of traffic in front and just decided to take a shot.
Yeah, unforced turnover there again for the Bulldogs. You got to, again, make sure you're taking care of those pucks. That's exactly how they scored their goal. High in the slot. Free puck right onto somebody's stick for the wrong team.
Right, I got you. Cooper Lagarde going to break up heavy on the far side, going to step around, can't get through the defense.
Got to get that deep.
Yeah, for sure. This is Jacob back all by himself, going to try to leave it up here, but there was a nice play by their defenseman.
Good
step
call.
Up. Live just calling offside. I'm not so sure, people. A lot of people in the house aren't agreeing with it, and I'm going to tell you they're wearing red.
In a different color of red as well.
That's it.
Not Bulldog red. I don't know. I looked good for it. Looked like it was off from here, but...
Well, you know, it's easy from up here, they say. But anyways, here we're going to have a face-off in the neutral zone. This is going to be English. He logging a lot of time, this English.
Yeah, well, with milling out, he's the third-line center, became second-line center overnight.
There you go. That's why you practice hard, right? You never know when you're going to get your chance.
Absolutely. He's making the best of it.
That's it. Cooper Lagarde going to put it up the boards. Doesn't make it out. Shot right in the Bulldog emblem. I'll tell you what, it was almost like a target. This is stuck right in the old breadbasket there, Eddie Coffman. But I'll tell you what, he sucked it up, and that was the end of that. All right, face off to the right of Kaufman. Here we are, 11:52 to go in the second period. 1-1 tie here at the House of Chills between your Meadville Bulldogs and the Crestwood Mustangs. Potassi going to chase her down, going to keep kept in deep there by the Mustangs. Puck going behind the net. Off the boards. Yeah, another unforced turn area there. I think we're just kind of feeding her point. We can't be doing that. This is Triola going to get the puck up to Greg. Yeah, you got him to get around that.
Good play by Triola to come back.
Yep, he's a seasoned. It's why he's a senior. He's seasoned. Uh-oh, well, that was a check there. Was that Gizzy going down?
No, that's it was English, wasn't
English.
It?
English, yeah. Oh, yeah, he'll be back. He's a tough kid. Look, him skating hard to get back into the play. Puck deep into the Meadville zone. Hoffman going to battle with a couple Mustangs. Here it comes out. There's English, what I tell you. Here we go. Oh, I'll tell you what, that would have been a one-on-one if we could have held it. He just couldn't hold on to the puck. Nice check here to finish off the check. Remind me to tell you something when we get a break. This is 2-on-1 if we hurry. This is Pasilla going to put the puck in front. Nice job by the defender to go down and block the puck. Puck's in front. Where is it? Oh, nicely done. Good back checking there by the Mustangs. They call them Maplewood D. I saw on one of their helmets, the one guy here, I can't remember what. He's, no, look at here. He's got number 27 on his bucket. He's got number 5. So I'm guessing these guys play for like multiple teams.
Yeah, I've seen a couple different logos on a couple different helmets as well for these guys. So yeah, I would definitely agree with it.
So I think what you said earlier, you know, how much do these guys play together? You know, how much they get the feel for one another. You know, that could be tough sometimes.
Absolutely.
Okay, well, here they go. 3-on-3. Puck's going to be offsides. Put back to the Mustang D. Bedina D going to put nice pass to number 10. Scooting up the middle. Nice shot. Good save by Kaufman, though, to kind of steer the puck into the corner. Puck in the near side, deep corner in Bulldog zone. That's going to be Jacobs fighting with two Mustangs. Puck comes out. Where is it? Hits somebody in the shoulder and goes back into the corner. Going to swing all the way around. Not enough to get for icing. Back to the Mustang D. Nice stop looking. That's a good job by that defenseman to move his feet. And a nice shot. That puck almost snuck in. That was a good play by that kid. By number 27. Of course, this isn't numerical. I can't tell you who his name is. Oh, that's Wrightley. That was a nice play. Puck side. Oh, I'll tell you what. If it just gets, yeah, I'm telling you, Cody. If that puck just gets past this defender, Vasilla's in. If we go, we're on sides. Nice play there by Franz. Going to step around. Nice tip in front there by Gizzy, but the puck just didn't go.
That's Weber in front.
Oh, Weber, my fault. They're about the same height.
Yeah, they are. Well, one number off, too.
Yeah, what happened to puck?
Off the netting, I believe.
The net's off the moorings.
No, the puck off the net, behind the net, I believe.
Oh, so where are we going to go?
Off a bulldog outside.
Okay, so we're going to have the face-off outside, 9:31 to go, second period, face-off outside, 1-1. Scoring started off with the Mustangs, started off early with an even strength goal, then Meadville tied it up with Luke Triola, scoring a power play goal. Here we go, Potassium. Here we go there, a little bit unlucky. Kaufman's going to come out and play the puck to the corner. Potassium's going to try to get it up, won't go. Here it is here, this is going to be Franz. Goes if he hurries. Oh, he made a nice move on that guy.
Good hip check, though.
Yeah, it was. He got taken down, though, but I'll tell you what, it took two guys to take him down.
Yeah, it usually does.
Yeah, so where's the puck? Steiner kind of keep it deep. Franz couldn't corral it. They're going to have to hold him. I'm telling you, they're going to have to hold him, and the only way to hold that Franz down. Where's he at? He's going to come out of the corner with a nice stick there defensively. Breaking out here is the Mustang. Going to put the puck deep. Could be icing. Klimo says yes. Vibel says no. Puck never made it to the end line. That's a good call by referee Mike Vibel. Here come the Bulldogs. Going to try to come up. Missed the pass all the way back to the Mustang D. Going to bring it to the stripe. Going to dump it deep. Right in on a goalie. Kaufman says he's going to hold on it, which is a smart move with two Mustangs breathing down his throat.
Yeah, a couple tired bodies. Here comes the cavalry now. Yeah, it was a definitely, like I said, it's a good play there. Good play there to get out of the zone. I tell you what, we got some patience with our wingers when we got the puck. We just that second pass in the neutral zone is hitting our stick, and we're not corralling it very well, not receiving the puck. I mean, it's too cold in here. Warm up your hands or something.
Yeah, I hear you. All right, this is Greg. Can't get the puck out. In behind is English. English is going to go all the way behind the net. Nice play there. Uh-oh, another guy lost an edge. That's Triola. That's like three guys that like lost an edge.
Okay. Triola was the early one, too, and Dickie Doo needs to do his skates.
Uh-oh. Yeah, I don't know. Here we go. Puck on the Jacob stick. Going to put it in neutral zone. English is going to tap and get around this guy. Saw it coming from here. Triolo and Jacob. This is going to be
Greg's
nice tip, and it didn't go in. That's a nice play by English to get that started. Tip it around the defenseman, kind of make a 3-on-2. Triolo makes a nice pass in front. And who was that, Steiner that had the tip, or was that Greg?
No, it was Greg that had the tip. Again, these guys don't normally play together
right.
On a normal line, so great chemistry with the three boys there,
right.
Absolutely.
Good stop. All right, Priscilla going to take the draw. Where is it, Felt? Where is it? There we go. Priscilla comes out with it. Another Houdini. Pucks are disappearing tonight now. To the point. That's going to be Jacob's shot. Nice tip there, but put it wide. It never made it to the goalie, but still nice job to get your stick on it. Shot there. Didn't make it through. Oh, now here we go. Oh, could he just got it to the goal. Nice shot by Priscilla, but just didn't make it through. Puck in deep. Puck's going in behind the Bulldog zone. 7:39 to go on a running clock. 1-1 here at the House of Chills. Kept in nicely there by the Mustangs at their blue line. Puck deep near side. Puck can put out front. 1-1 if we hurry. Gizzy, can he get there? No. This is Leach. He can't keep it in either. So Gizzy's going to have to get onside. But we change and watch our change. Here we go. Puck coming up the other way. Uh-oh. Nothing called there.
No. Well, good no call.
That's a good no call. Yeah, who knows what would have happened. Well, here we go. Puck deep around. Far side in the Bulldog zone. Mustangs are fighting. Anything can happen here. Get it out of there. Too much snow. Uh-oh. Lost it. I tell you, there's a bunch of snow there. Kind of slowed the puck up there a little
bit.
Yeah,
you can still see the skid park of where the puck was.
I see that. High off the glass. This is going to be icing. We're going to have an icing here. Yeah, so we got 6:52 in the second period, 1-1. We're going to have a face-off in our zone. We have an icing call. It's a little different game today, DJ.
Absolutely. You know, much better pace to it. You know, Monday was just so choppy with all those penalties. Much better pace here tonight or even this afternoon in the Army. Like you said, there's all that snow. Again, got Patassi all looked up in the corner.
Yeah, oh, good play there. Patassi, nice play there to get the puck. Oh, I'll tell you what, we won. One little hitchy-hatchy away from getting it around the guy there.
Franz is due to break three here because he's got about that a couple times. Not a bad call there by Klimo for the offsides.
Yeah, I think it's a good
call. Hoffman didn't like it, but yeah, you're right. I mean, he's one hitch away from getting free here on all
these
guys.
He is. I'll tell you what, these guys are, you know, these guys aren't slouches. I mean, they're, you know, they're playing, you know, these kids have probably been playing hockey since, you know, they know what, you know, little guys. So, I mean, they understand what's going on. I bet they face a lot of good competition during the year, but one of these times, I've got a feel that Franz has got to break loose.
Here we go, 2-on-1.
Priscilla with Gizzy, going to put the puss over the front. Gizzy shot,
nice.
Scores! What a shot by Gizzy. What a shot by Gizzy, huh?
Yeah, he goes upstairs right away.
Wow, nicely done, Meadville.
Great play by Priscilla, way to get elevated enough, just enough to get over the defenseman's stick right on Gizzy, and he goes right upstairs, like right now.
All right, we're going to put a score on. This is 6:21 left to go in the third. Or in a second, I mean. So we know it's Gizzy. It's going to be Gizzy from Pasil. I don't know if there's going to be another one or not here. We'll have to listen.
Yeah, I'm not sure if Leach might have had a tip on that or if it came
from the
defenseman.
Where was it? Yeah. 2-1, Meadville. There's a little, looks like a rugby scrum at center ice there. All right, here we go. There's Potassi going to wheel and deal, turn back the other way. Nice play, though. This other guy was waiting for him to put it around the net. Attaboy, Eddie. Can't be doing anything silly now. Got to protect the puck.
Leach got the second assist there.
Leach got the second assist. Okay, so here we go. So we ended up with Gizzy from Priscilla and Leach. And that would be Chase Leach.
That's correct.
Yeah, 36. Okay.
36.
That was with 6:21 to go left in the second period. 2-1 Meadville. Okay, what we got to do now is just play smart. Nice play there to keep the puck in. Here we go. Back the other way. Greg's going to get it. Keep it deep. You know the MO. That's what we got to do. Puck in behind the zone. Good check there. Puck in front. Take all the way back to Cooper Lagarde. Nice job to keep it in. That kid's got good skating ability.
Yeah, between him and Jacobs. Boy, let me tell you.
I'll tell you what. He's big kid, too. Cooper Lagarde. He's a good kid. Big kid. Okay. Shot by Jacobs. Where'd it go?
Where do you guess? High. That kid, I don't think he can keep it below the net.
I know. There's Lagarde going to move. He's familiar territory down there where because he plays back down there too. Two periods out of a game. Nice job by Jacob. Steps is going to get a shot. He puts a shot on.
And it is.
And it's in the net. Nice shot by Jacobs. Nice upper 90 there. Did it? I'm not sure where it came from.
It came right from the, I believe the Mustangs. I don't know that it came from 30 unassisted. I believe it was a turnover. I tell you what, it's a good thing Jacob's great play to step right in front of the defender, keep the puck in. He goes right around the Mustang guy. And it's a good thing he was close to the circle because he knows he likes to go upstairs. If he was any further away, it would have missed the net.
I'll tell you what.
Great shot, though. Absolutely great shot. Upper 90, right in the corner, I believe, when you see the replay. Right in the corner.
Yeah, that kid's that good, too, because I've actually played hockey with him. I played hockey with his dad, and he skated with us a few times. Kid's that good. I mean, he's good. He's a good kid. Nice kid, good kid. All right, here we go. 3-1, 5:06 to go in the second period. Your Meadville Bulldogs are up here at the House of Chills. We got the puck in behind our neck, and all we got to do is just not stop doing what we're doing. Right, DJ?
Absolutely. Well, the biggest thing here is not to let off the gas. We got to continue to be on the gas. Make sure you're getting it deep, doing what you said like the recipe earlier. Keep it deep, and let's keep going.
Right. And puck's off the glass. This is Franz going to turn and look. Oh, can't get around the defenseman. Nice play there. Checking hard to keep the puck down. Here we go. 2-on-2, dumping in deep by Crestwood. Mustangs are going to put it in deep. This is Hoffman going to get the puck behind the net, far side, tried to put it up. Nice tip there by Franz, just enough to elevate it, right?
Yeah, got it right out of midair.
Give it to him. Nice job. This is Steiner going to look for Franz in front. I'm telling you, blocked by the defense. Nice play to the defense. Shot on goal. Nice save by the goalie. At the fair, yeah, I know. Franz is like, you know, his stick's behind the net or in the net. He doesn't even have a stick. Some guy knocked it out of his hand. Steiner was looking for him, but the defenseman made a nice play. He went Titanic on him, went down, blocked the path. I'm expecting for a goal right now. I got to believe Hoffman's got to get one of these days. What do you think, Dean?
Well, I tell you what, he gets another free look. If it gets through, it's in. There's no doubt.
Yeah, he can boom him. All right, puck way back here at the zone. This is Casilla going to leave it for Hoffman. He's going to keep it deep. No. Puck battle along here by the near blue line. There you go. Nice job there by Leach to put a body on somebody. There's a shot there, high and wide. Oh, boy, that was a singer. Good play there to get the puck out. No high stick call. Good job by Leach to put some pressure on him. This kid's pretty slick. He's pretty nifty.
Yeah, there's three Bulldogs created right by him.
Nice job. I'll tell you what, this kid's their version of Franz.
Yeah, that's their captain, Adam Green.
Yeah, he's pretty 10. Good. Here comes Priscilla. 2-on-2 if he hurries. He's got Gizzy. Gizzy already has one. This combination already worked for one. Got to keep the puck deep, though. Don't do anything now. 3:38 to go on a running clock. Attaboy, Gizzy, stepping in. Or two men on the puck. That's like a rule there, Hundy.
Absolutely, yeah. You got to help your teammate out there.
Especially in the offensive zone. Here we go. 2-on-3. Puck's going to come all the way out. They're going to have to clear. They're going to dump it in. They're going to have to still clear. Offside. They got people scattered everywhere. Klimo's yelling offside. There we go. Nicely done. We had the free zone. Puck back to their D. Mustang's going to put a puck all the way down. Tipped in there. Nicely. Hoffman's going to try to clear it in, but he can't. Puck's in behind him. Just missed his skate in behind the zone. Oh, we got the...
Axel's out there.
Axel!
Yeah, he did a good poke check there just a moment ago.
Oh, good. Oh, there's a whiff. Here we go. Can the puck get out? Get it out of there. Yeah, Greggs gets it out. Triola. Awesome. Good call. Good call by Vodge. He played the puck on an offside. So we got Axel over there on the ice.
Yeah, is it Yager? Is that how you pronounce it?
Yeah. We got Axel Yager. And I'll tell you what, I just found out what their roster is good for.
a little bit of coffee.
Just a little bit. Watch, that's wet. I'll tell you what, never a dull moment. I was going to ready to drink that. All right, here we go. 2:48 to go in the period. I should have put it on the floor. Puck kept deep by Greg. Trying to fight off the defender. Puts it in front. You know, see, there's snow. I mean, it's like playing on pond hockey there in front.
Yeah, it doesn't seem to get that snowy when we go out there. I'm not sure why that is.
Well, maybe we're not skating that hard.
That's
I don't
my
know
point.
What
we're not really skating as hard as these boys are.
All right. Here we are. We got 2:26 to go. Third period, DJ. You're going to have to help me with the Crestwood roster if something happens, because I'll tell you why. Mine's swimming.
We need a little squeegee action here. I'm not sure. I think
squeegee.
2 minutes for spillage.
I need more than a squeegee. I need that Zamboni up here. I need a scuba tank.
Right.
All right, here we go. Here we go.
The good news is it was decaf.
That's right. So my roster's not going to get goofy. Here we go. Breaking it out. Here we go. 2-on-2. We hurry. Oh, here, just in behind. Leach. Good job to stay on side. Franz put the puck deep into the Crestwood area. Down by the Zamboni door. And we got a fight going on. Not a fight, but a scrum. Well, not a scrum. The boys are just after the puck. This is Priscilla going to come out. Oh, we still got people down. That's Leach and one of their guys.
Oh, now, Leach didn't like it.
No, there's going to be, something's going to come, something bad's going to come out of this.
Just sat a guy down.
Well, I know, but we got to watch. puck kept in there nice by Lagarde. Tipped
tip.
Up. Was that our guy or
I
their
think it was
guy?
Defenseman. It was not a good tip to get it out.
This is Pasilla going to look to wrap around. Gets knocked into the net. Now the goalie, he's going to have something to say.
He didn't like that, did he?
He did not like that. But I got to tell you, his own guy knocked Pasilla in there,
didn't he?
That's
why the faceoff's inside.
You know, DJ, we know all the rules. All right, here we go. Here's the situation. 3-1 Bulldog, 1:40 to go in the second period. My roster is completely soaking wet. Toes are cold. I'm excited right now. Here we go.
We're having fun.
Here we are. Face off deep into the Mustang zone. Going to come right to Gizzy. Oh, swing and a miss. I wonder if he plays baseball. Shot wide of the goal there by Triola. Deep in behind the zone. It's going to come around. Can they break out? Nice play there by the winger to put the puck off the board so this guy can pick it up. Shot there. Nice save by Eddie Kaufman. Good play there to get the puck up and out of the zone. Good job there by English.
Yes.
That guy never ceases to. He's getting better and better.
He really is.
Keeping it deep. You can hear it from the bench here. 1:09 to go on a running clock. Just about 1 minute to go in the second period. 3-1 Bulldogs. We'll recap everything you need to know at the end of the period. There you go. Back the other way goes Crestwood. Nice job there by Gizzy to get a stick in there. Kid makes a, turns and makes a shot. Good save by Kaufman. Here's a puck to the point. Going to walk the line. Nice job. And a boy, Gizzy gets something in front of it. Anything. Puck's off the glass. Can't make it. It's going to be a hand pass. Oh, nice job there. Icing?
Nice.
He had a call. It's a good call.
That's all right. Klimo missed. He missed it. Franz touched it with his skate, but he missed it.
That's okay.
He was turned. That's all right.
No, that's okay. We don't want any miscombobulations here. Okay, all we got to do is win the faceoff. 39 seconds to go. Here we go. 39 seconds to go in the second period. 3-1 Bulldogs. They're gonna talk it over.
Yeah, he's gonna see if Vibes Raw saw him. I don't know if Vibes saw him or not, but two Bulldogs touched it on the other side of the other side of the red. He's just confirming to see if his back judge helped him out or not.
You know what they tell? That's what the book says. They're confirming to see if he erred in icing. The book says if the referee errs in icing.
That's right. Yeah.
Face off goes. What is that word?
It's I can tell you what, again, I think sometimes we call this a trump card.
That's it.
Jamie doesn't talk very often much to the refs, but he just yelled at him. And I think he said, all right, well, let me go ahead and check with my partner. His partner said, yeah, he touched on the other side of the red. Now we're inside the Crestwood zone.
There we go.
Nice. There's play that, by Franz.
Yeah, I'm telling you, that'll hit you, get you. I'm telling you, he does that. He's got good hands.
Absolutely.
29 seconds cut to keep the puck deep on a running clock. No stupid. No penalties. Don't get him to come out with fresh eyes. This guy here is number. I can't tell you his name because it's smeared on my sheet, DJ. Number eight for
Carson. Carson Hartwig.
Oh, nice save there.
Remember that one.
Remember that one is right. Nice save by Eddie Kaufman. Way to be in the game. Yeah, I think this kid's out there because this kid's a player.
Yeah, Carson Hartwig. He's again on the little bit of schedule they have. Oh, here's Trill.
He's got no time.
No time.
Nice shot.
He's their number one point getter. Again, from the records we have in seven games, I believe he's got 11 points in just seven games, six goals and five assists. So he's definitely one to watch, and obviously that number 10 has got room to dangle too.
That's it. Okay, so I don't know what we're talking over. There's going to be 15 minutes. I'm sure there's going to be an intermission. I'm going to try to find a mop. Let me see if we can get our shots on goal here. Meadville had 9 shots on goal. Crestwood had 11 for a two-period total of 18 for Crestwood and
20 for Meadville.
20 for Meadville, higher math, Deej. Okay, we're going to have a little intermission. What do you think, Deej? What do you say to them? I mean, you know, there's a lot of stuff you can tell going in there, but what do you think?
Yeah, I mean, I think that obviously came out a lot better in the first period, continued there the second period, and had a much better puck possession time. I mean, it's a puck possession time, obviously. We're looking the one way almost the whole time. But I tell you what, you got to give a lot of credit to the defensemen. They've had a lot of pokes, a lot of stops in front. Eddie Kaufman standing well when he does see some shots. Got a lot more action there in the second period. But you got to keep status quo, I think, at this point. Keep the hammer down. Let's go ahead and finish this thing off, and let's get the proverbial 1K.
That's it. I'll tell you what, we're going to be back at the end of the intermission. We've got the Zamboni coming out. We may have a little extended intermission because I'm going to have her come up here and swipe my desk. Because I am Oh, you got to see it. You got to love it. All right, we'll see you here right after the intermission. Ready to roll. Here we are, DJ, back for the third period.
Recapping, we had Crestwood Mustangs get off to an early lead, 1-0, and with Meadville tied it by Triolo from an assist from Cooper Lagarde. And then we went ahead with a goal by Gizzy, assisted by Pasilla and Leach. And then we had a Jacobs with an unassisted goal. So here we go. We got to take care of business here. Fresh sheet of ice. This is Leach going to bring the puck in, going to put it in front. Pasilla can't get to it. Going to keep in there by Gizzy. Gizzy can't make it through. Here we go. Face coming back the other way. Jacobs, nice job to keep the puck from going any farther. This is Franz going to dump it in deep. I'm sorry, that's
Cooper Lagarde.
Cooper Lagarde, my fault. Puck in front, where to go? I don't know. Cooper, he's stepping up nice today, Cooper. They may be trying to float some people. I don't know. They might have saw some films from Monday. I don't know how that goes. That's a good job to keep the puck in. Uh-oh.
Good call.
Klimo's calling offside.
That's a good call.
It was a good call.
Yeah, it was offsides. It's a good call. Close guy, Vibes waved it off. He's called it good, but good call here from the far side. He had a bad angle at it. It was a good call.
Good job, Klimo, then. Nice job. Way to be on it. Okay. Face off to the neutral zone. Puck's going to be put deep into the, not deep, but into the Meadville zone. This is going to be Hoffman going to pop it ahead. Too far there for Triola. Puck's going to scoot all the way down. Icing's called by Mr. Vibram. Yo. Hey, boy, let me tell you, you know, you just don't know who's going to be up here every once in a while.
Boy, we got to put a lock on that gate down there.
Dr. Denny Finn just joined us in the booth. How's it going, Doc?
Good.
He's looking. Floss him if you got him, he says. Spoken by a true dentist. Good to see you. Good to see you. Of course, his son Cole, you know, was a standout here for the Bulldogs. And also, or not Cole, but Drew. Cole was also a player. But anyways, long story short, good to have Dr. Fitton on board here. Okay, this is, that was Triola. Going to keep the puck deep in behind the Bulldog zone. Mustangs looking to clear it out. Going to go, east to west on this one. This is Potassi going to put it deep. Icing, no way, no icing, no nothing. Put the arm down, Claims. Here we go.
Keep the clock rolling.
Keep the clock rolling, Claimer. Here we go. Puck can be put in deep. No, stop there by Hoffman. Going to put the puck back the other way. Now Vibes going to call icing. We got more arms up, I got to tell you. Here we go. 13:32 on the stop clock. We're going to have a face-off just left to goaltender Edward Kaufman IV.
Yeah, again, as we mentioned in the off-air, in the break, the Bulldogs got to keep the throttle down here. Let's see if they can get it going, get out of our zone, and keep it in the Mustang zone.
All right, here we go. Face off in the deep in the zone. Going to come out now. This is there's Franz there. Yeah, nice. Oh, I'm not sure. It's a tough call there by Vibes, but he got it there. I think Weber might have been Steiner was just a step ahead of the game. It's hard to tell some of these numbers. You know, they got this Gretzky tucked the sweater into the pants thing, DJ.
Yeah, I know. There's a lot of numbers that are hard to tell. That's for sure. When they're tucking it in.
They got eights look like threes. Threes look like eights. Here we go. Franz can't get around the defenseman here. Steiner's going to keep it deep. No, going to stop there by the Mustang defense. Go D to D. Put the puck up front. Not all the way out. Nice job there by. That was Weber to keep it in. Shot there by Steiner, but missed the net. This is Franz going to take it in behind the Mustang net. Wheeling deal. Back the other way he goes. He's got this guy chasing him like he needs lunch money.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a swing and a miss there by Cooper Lagarde, but somehow the Bulldogs end up with a nice pass there. Another nice pass.
Good luck.
Little tic-tac-toe, but the puck never went in. Oh, that was a nice play there.
Steiner's going to want that one back.
Yeah, he is.
Well, like you said, Cooper Lagarde makes a whiff at the blue line, then the Mustangs just found each other face-to-face, fell over. Puck was nice there. Left over by, who was it? I think it was Weber that found Franz and then had Steiner back door. Just couldn't finish it home.
Just couldn't get her done. Okay, Mustangs are going to try to clear it out. No, won't make it through. This is Pasilla going to keep it deep and then also gets help by Leach. Here's Pasilla going to try to get the puck again. Now it finally comes out. There's Potassi going to reel it, and you know where it's going to go. Dak behind the net. Good play there. 12:21 to go on a running clock. This is Gizzy. Heads up. Puts it deep. Can't make it to Pasilla. Gizzy's going to still look for it again. No way. This is Hoffman at the line. Going to keep it deep. Bulldogs got it clear. He wheels and deals. Going to step around one guy. He's going to take a shot. I'm telling you. He's going to pass. Nice in front. Oh, my. I think his pass was so hard, he almost knocked Gizzy over.
He did, didn't he?
Now, here's the scenario.
We got Barrett Hoffman, who's so well over 6 foot. We got Gizzy, who's probably just a little bit under 6 foot. The pass from Hoffman, I think, almost knocked him off. God bless that little guy. But I'll tell you what, he plays big. That Gizzy plays big. You got to love him. He's got a good goal this game.
Absolutely. He'll come back hard the next one. You know that.
Yes, he will. Can't keep him down. Barrett Hoffman's going to take a slap shot through the defense. There's what you're talking about earlier. You know, if they get in the way and the goalie doesn't see it, that puck can get in.
Yeah, just got to sneak by the defender because the goalie's not seeing anything.
This is Greg going to try to get the puck deep. He does. Back behind the English, going to tap it in front, but nobody's there but the Mustang. Going to put it up along the boards. Go if they hurry. That's Potassi going to break it up to Greg. Greg going to try to put it ahead, block there at the defense. This is Triola going to make a move. Puts it off the defenseman's ankle. Goes in behind. Going to go one-on-one with him. Out they come with the puck. Nice job there. Going to come all the way over here into the skates of number 77, but he keeps it deep. And then Hoffman decided, you know, nothing. Enough of that.
Well, he's just looking at his skates the whole time. He's lucky he didn't get hit earlier.
That's it. Yeah. Icing on the Bulldogs. 11-11 to go in the third period. 3-1. Now, last time we had a bunch of 3Ds. We got a bunch of 1s down there.
That's right. Unless it was a bunch of 3s and a 5. Now we got a bunch of 1s and a 3.
Higher math. Okay, here we go. Face off to the right of Coffin. Face off won by the Mustangs, but it doesn't. They can't control it. They're going to hurry up. Fonz is going to be 2-on-1 if they hurry. This is Fonz going to take a shot. Nice save there by the goalie. Try to sneak it in 5-hole. That was a good shot, actually. But
yep.
He had Steiner in front, but I'm not sure he had a good alley to pass it to him anyway.
No, maybe off the far pad. That was about it.
Yeah. So that's a good take. Cooper Lagarde, nice job to keep the puck in to deep in behind the Crestwood net. Back here to Jacobs. Jacobs is going to take a shot. Nice save there. A little rebound. Steiner can't get there in time. Defense stepped in front. We're going to have a face-off in front of their goalie. I'll tell you what, during intermission, my little lake got cleaned up. I just have a little quagmire now over here. I hope this is pressure-treated wood because I was swimming. All right, here we go. Face off deep into the zone. Back around, Jacob's going to stand up. No, decides not to. Comes back to the line. Smart move there. Franz going to put it back to him. Jacob in front. Nice tip there by Steiner. I think kind of ping-ponged off the goalie and hit the pole and everything else. Here we go. Oh, another overskate. I'll tell you what, they're having some hard time here. Crestwood getting out of their own zone. It's kind of similar to what happened in the first period.
Yeah, absolutely. Coming on strong here for the Bulldogs. Hopefully they can capitalize on one here.
Yeah, they need to. They're skating pretty good. Weber going to chase him down. Going to put him in the boards. Going to high loft into the zone. All the way back. Going to be icing.
Took a funny bounce off the side of the boards there to kind of go up and over, but that's okay. Advantage Bulldogs with the icing. Again, keep it in mind here that Pasil was on actually that last rush, the defensive zone. Pasil was on there for the draw, and then they switched out Weber as they went north towards the Mustang end. So keep in mind there. You're probably going to keep a lot of defensemen. There's a shot.
Oh, nice play there, Pasil, to get the puck to Leach, but couldn't finish. Goalie made a nice save on that one. Here's Pasil in near corner, going to wheel and deal. Look, walk the line. Going to put it out. No, going to try to keep put it across, but hit the skate. Stayed in the zone. This is Leach, going to put it into Gizzy. Gizzy's going to take on two defenders. Put puck put in front. There we go. Mustang's going to break out. Wheeling to his own line. Chased down by Leach. Nice job to pinch him off. Puck going the other way. Going to be a delayed offside. There's Gizzy going to put ahead to Leach. Leach going to dump it deep. No high stick call. Here we go. Back the other way. Mustang break it out. Neutral zone. No. Stays in. I think it must have come out. From my vantage point, I couldn't see it. Okay, here we go. 9:29 to go, third period. We're going to have English out here with Triola and Greg. We got Jacobs and Cooper Lagarde on defense. Puck's put in deep, hit him offside. That's a good call there. That's a good call. You're offside, hit him in the shin.
Spot of the pass.
That spot of the pass is right. Triola just told Jacob, keep it down a little bit, and Jacobs is laughing.
He said that is down. I was at his shin. What else does he want me to do?
I was
better
say,
at his head.
That's as low as it gets for Jacobs. Here we go. Back the other way goes the Mustangs. Wheel and deal. Top of the circle. Nice save there by Kaufman. Hang on to it. Why not?
Same kid that scored their first goal, number 4.
Is it really?
Yeah.
This time he went a little lower.
Yeah, he didn't. I don't think he got all of it on there. He's the big boy, that number 4.
That's it. Here we're going to have a change in the guard here. Fresh troops for the Lakewood Mustangs.
They got a neat little flag on their shoulder there.
Crestwood.
Yeah, they got a neat little flag there on their shoulder for the Crestwood Mustangs. They're written right here. Shot hit that English and deflected into the corner. The guard's going to take the body on the guy. They really hit him hard, just enough to move him off the puck. Back to the top of the circle, shot there. Nice save by Coffin. We can't get too complacent here, DJ. We still got 8:51 on the third period.
Yep, got to get it out.
Got to get the puck out here. Nice
break
out here. Oh, we get hurry up. 2-on-1 if we hurry. Nice try there, but a good play by the defenseman for the Mustangs to break that up. It was, again, just one, about 3 inches away from an odd man rush.
Yeah, almost trying to be too cute there.
Yeah, nice poke check there by Jacobs. Puck's going to go far side board. Stop, wheel, and deal. Cooper guard just enough to take the guy off. Shot in front. There's going to be a shot here at the point. No, Jacobs is going to get to it. What was that?
That was Triola.
That was Triola? Yeah, I got couldn't see what was going on. But here we go again. Back in front. Oh, nice move there. Shot. Oh, that was a nice save by Kaufman. Puck into the near board corner. Going to loft it up. Is he going to make icing? Icing's called. And icing will be called.
Yeah, it just got across the red. Yeah, like you said there, it was a good save there by Eddie. He was actually leaning to his right. Shot came back to his left, low glove side. Was able to get the left pad on it. Good save. Keep him in it here. Keep him plus two on the scoreboard.
There we go. Got to hear what you're saying. All right, so 8:03 to go, third period. 3-1 Bulldogs. Shot here from the point. Save there. Oh, rebound. Nice job there by Kaufman to get a stick on that.
Yeah, Hoffman maybe even helped out too.
There we go. This is Franz going to try to keep it deep. Instead, he keeps the puck moving ahead. That was ahead to Pasilla, but Pasilla couldn't beat the last guy. Shot in deep. Hoffman's going to get there first. Going to shoot the puck all the way around. Kept in nicely there by Crestwood. Put back to the point. Going to go D to D. No, going to keep it deep on the other side. This is Potassi. Going to pump the puck ahead. Got to get the puck out. Here we go. 1-on-1. 2-on-1. Franz gets the puck. Here we go. 2-on-2. He's going to leave it there for Leach. Takes a shot high and wide. Puck behind the net, fighting for it. Where is it at? They have the puck in behind their zone. Mustangs are going to try to break it out. Coming up center of the ice, going to look to pass it out. He's going to skate it himself. He's going to put it ahead. Guy wasn't really paying attention for it. It was kind of a pass, and he just didn't see it. Hoffman tried to break in, but it was offside. Meadville. You know, sometimes you like to get a flow of the game, but sometimes you like a lot of whistles, but I sure would like to see if we could stay onside and get this clock running.
Yeah, I wonder if you're not going to see some. It looked like that last line there. You had Vasilla back with Franz. I'm wondering if you're going to see Jamie shorten up the bench here, maybe potentially for the rest of the game.
Well, we'll see.
Keep an eye on that.
We'll definitely see. We saw Yager once, right? Well, that was towards the end of the second period.
Yeah, I don't know that you're going to see any more of those guys here the rest of the game.
We'll see. I don't know. You know, it's. I guess that's why he's the coach. We'll let him decide what to do there.
Yeah.
Puck's in deep. Gizzy puts it deep. Nice job. He's with Triola and English. Gizzy goes, gets the puck. It's knocked over, but that's okay. This is English going to turn, wheel and deal. Gets behind the far zone. Going to put it out to the point. Never made it. Stopped there by their winger. Nice outlet pass there. Crestwood hard near side. Going to go into the corner. Put it in front. Nice job there. Here we go. Steiner's got a breakaway if he hurries. Takes a shot. Had him, but just a little bit too far over the net. This is Cooper Lagarde. He takes the shot. I'll tell you what, sacrificed his own body to keep the puck deep and took a hit at the end. Nice job there by Cooper Lagarde. That's a tough position to be in. You're standing flat-footed. You got an opponent coming in your face. Your job is to keep it deep. That's hard to do.
Absolutely. Steiner made a nice play, brought it down with his glove. Almost got a, had a good second chance there.
Yep, that's for sure. 6:18 to go in the third period. Face-off won by Pasilla, all the way back, kept in there by Lagarde. Back they come the other way, 3-on-3. Puck's going to go deep into the zone. Back out in front. Back comes Pasilla. 3-on-2 if they hurry. Nice check there, but Pasilla works through it. He's got a couple guys in front. Oh, boy, good step up there by Jacobs. Nice pass by Pasilla, but he just couldn't find the net. Back the other way comes Crestwood. Stop on a dime. Loses the skate, puts the puck in front. Kaufman's going to say, let's get a line change.
Boy, I tell you what, way to jump in the play there by Jacobs. Good right. Heads-up play. I mean, he sees the opening. I mean, you mentioned Chris Letang's name earlier. I'll love Chris Letang in the zone there. Just almost just on the outside of the pipe there, wasn't it? Just right. On the outside of the net.
Yeah. That was a good play by Pasilla to fight through a check and get the get the puck in front of the net.
Good back check as well. He was almost there for the.
Leach moving hard, moving, yeah, feet moving all the time. Nice wheels there. Going to put the pass over to, what was that, Patassi?
Yeah, Patassi. I think he was trying to take a shot there. Again, defenseman really jumping into the play here very nicely.
Yeah.
He can hit the defenseman in front.
That's good. It's nice. It's nice that the defenseman's jumping in. The other defenseman's got to be sensitive to that, but, you know, a winger that's caught back's got to be sensitive too. You should always have, you know, somebody back, you know, in the backside there.
Yeah, don't want to get caught with four down low.
No, that's not going to be good. Bulldogs, draw one. Patassi going to step up, take a shot. It's off somewhere. Goalie didn't see it. Deflects into the near corner. Good steal there by Franz. Guy can't even hold him. Franz is going to wheel and deal. Can't put skate back
nice
and forth.
Play.
In the zone.
There he is.
Nice play there by Franz.
Yeah, ducked around a couple guys right inside the blue line. Puck got into his skates. He fished it right out. I think he went 5-hole, I believe.
There's that hitchy-hotchy I told you about, huh?
Yeah, we called that he was going to get it. Obviously, he's a safe bet. He's going to score a goal. But I tell you what, that was a nice play by a shifty player.
Yeah, I told you about the hitchy-hotchy.
He likes it.
He does. Is that unassisted?
You know, I don't know if he got a pass up from him or not.
I don't know. We'll see if we can hear it. Face off in the neutral zone. Whoever takes a draw gets the puck back again.
Unassisted.
Okay, unassisted by Franz to make it 4-1, 5:17 to go. Oh, heads up. Puck in the bench or did it go over the bench?
It went over the glass next to the bench.
Almost
took out the Zamboni driver.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'm looking at the crowd. I see a lot more smiling faces this place than we did this time on Monday, DJ.
Yeah, it's a little different story here. 4-1, 5:14 left in the third period.
Good crowd on hand. All right, here we go. We're going to stay as long as we can. We're going to just, we got 5:14 to go in this game. Face off just in the top of the circle here, closest to us, new side boards. Klimo going to drop the puck. He's going to put his heel down and say, right there, fellas. See my heel? Right there. All right, here we go. You'll be surprised where centers will ask you where it's going to go. Puck out of the zone. Put back in. It's going to be delayed offside. So everybody's clear. People are guard. Oh, can't get it out. Yes, it does. It's the guy in the knee. This is going to be a delayed offside. Puck come back the other way. Nice tip there by Pasilla to get the puck to Gizzy. Gizzy puts it deep. Back in behind the net. All the way out to the zone. Cooper Lagarde again. Just going to dribble one in.
Nice boy. Tip by Triola.
I know. Triola gets a piece on it. Almost bounced in. There goes Gizzy. There goes his stick. There goes everything. All right. We're just going to play smart here. Back come the...
Yeah, you got to call that one.
Back come the Mustangs. All right, we got a trip on somebody.
Trip or a hook on
Triola. He's calling a trip.
Yeah. Yep. Okay. So it should be on Triola.
Okay, Meadville has a 2 minute for a trip on Triola. All right, so, you know what's nice about this? You can ice the puck.
Yeah. Man advantage for the Mustangs, but absolutely.
Well, we'll see what happens here.
4:30 left, 4.5 left here, 2 minutes on the clock.
Triola in the sin bin for tripping. That's a good call, though. I mean, you got to call that one.
Yeah, you got to call it. Again, offensive zone for the Mustangs. You got to call it.
There's a shot saved by Kaufman. Where'd he take it?
I mean, taking it in the face there. I don't know. It's a good save, nonetheless.
I'll tell you what, for a little guy, he stands tall, too. He's a good goaltender, that
he's
guy.
He's made some saves tonight that has definitely helped.
Yeah, he's coming out English. English is out there for... Oh, who's he taking off? Priscilla, give him a break. Now Gizzy doesn't know it. He's coming off back and forth. This is what they call a yo-yo change, DJ. Yeah. Back and forth. Back. Huh?
It's not a running clock.
It's on a running clock. Okay, far side. See what the Crestwoods got their power play for the first time tonight. Only a second power play overall. One for Meadville, one for Crestwood. Gonna stick hand. Oh, he lost his outside. One too many Gizzy gadgets on that one. Gonna look to put it on the far side. Gonna get the stripe. Is he gonna put it deep? Is he gonna stick handle? He gets the line. Takes a shot, Kaufman holds it and says, yeah, why not? Okay, 4:01 to go. Third period, 1:31 to go in the penalty, the tripping penalty to Luke Triola. Face off to the right of goaltender Ed Kaufman. Puck in behind the net. Hoffman's going to just send it all the way around. Does it make the line? No. Now we got a two on one. We got Franz. Going to give it to Leach. Oh, nice play by the defenseman. Nice play by the goalie. Nice job. Two nice plays there by the defense. One by the defender and one by the goalie to kind of stop that two on one. I thought for sure that was going to be a be a winner, but I'll tell you what, they made a nice play there.
Oh, here goes Franz on a breakaway. This is trouble. Let's see what happens. Let's see if he ices it, makes a move, puts it in the net. It's all over. Franz with a goal. Franz with a goal! He shoots and scores! Shorthanded goal!
Boy, it's nice to return the favor.
Yeah. Shorthanded goal, Nicky Franz. I didn't get the assist. Help me out on that one, D.
I don't know if, I'm not sure if he got an assist there or not. It might have bounced, I think it bounced off the player if Leach tipped it up to him.
Okay, we'll wait and see. But
one of the two.
At any rate, here we go.
He got it often.
Why is he? Oh, it must be something. That must be a certain goal for. He took the puck.
He did. He gave it right to Chief. He put it in his pocket. Yeah, Hoffman had the assist.
All right, so we got Franz from Hoffman. We got 3:23 to go. Here we go in the third period. Pasilla's trying to get the puck out in front. Can't do it. He's willing to deal. Nice job through three guys. Poke check there. Good job by Jacobs just to stay back. No need to be pinching now. With 3:11 to go with a four-goal lead. You know, you just want to, you know, just kind of ride this one out, DJ.
Absolutely. And again, shorthanded still here for another 30 seconds. But like you said, I mean, it's definitely keep it deep. Let's not let anything too crazy happen here. But, yeah, just get it out of the zone. Get it deep. No word for the worst there to get it deep.
That's it. You know, the other thing, too, is you want to get out of here with somebody getting hurt or getting another penalty. You don't want anybody more suspensions. So let's just play it smart, and I think we will. 11 seconds to go in the power play. Forecheck there, nice. But the Mustangs are able to come out. Lost control, back we go the other way.
Here comes Triola.
Okay, so we're at even strength. It almost looks like the Mustangs are just kind of slowed up a little bit here, DJ.
Yeah, I think 5-1, too, with just under 2.5 left to play. I think they see the writing on the wall as well.
Yeah, I can't imagine what else is going on here. All right, so here we go. We're going to have a face-off deep in the Bulldog zone. Why? Because we had a high sticking call. That's why. And that's what the rule says. So we're going to go all the way down to the right of the goaltender, Ed Kaufman. Face-off here.
Hey, Miller.
I'm not sure who's taking it.
Taking the shot,
up and over, up and over Kaufman's shoulder there, but he missed the net. That's a good thing. I'm not sure that puck might have rolled in. Can't get the puck out. Puck up and over the glass. So who we have out here? We've got Weber, Franz. Nope, they're going to make a change. Oh, we got a whole new line coming out here now. Now we got 34. That's Brendan Leach. He's going to be on the right wing. We got number 15 out there, which is Cody Pasilla, as we know. And number 20
is Merriman.
So we got Pasilla between Merriman and another Leach. And then we got Yager up on the defense. He's got his job worked out for him here. Puck's going to go deep. Yager's got to hustle. Goes back to get it. Wings it all the way around. This is Pasilla going to try to tap it ahead. Doesn't make it. Nice play by Yager with his skate. You know, he's a good soccer player. Here goes Pasilla, going to break down. Can he get around him? Yes, he does. Going to take a shot. Nice save. Good save by the goalie. Nice play there by Yager to go from skate to stick to get the puck, to move the puck out of the zone. So nice job, Yager. Here we go. Now we're going to have a face-off. 1:43 to go. Here, and oh, we got peak. We got smiles down there, and rightfully so. I'll tell you what, no wonder Dr. Finn's here. I see more chiclets here than I do in a confectionery drugstore.
Job security,
that's right.
Oh, off the crossbar there from Priscilla.
Everybody's smiling now. Here we go, we got to stay calm. Here we go, back the other way. This, one of their better players, that tried to toe drag it. Leach going to get the puck out, nice move. Cooper. Just to get it out, yeah, just a nice job to get it out of there.
Good poke by Cooper Lagarde on that forward.
Yeah, he's puck in front, oh, he shot it wide. I'll tell you what, that could have been two for them. 1:18 to go, running clock. Don't forget the puck. Can't have two guys checking somebody and forget the puck. Yeah, the puck is deep in behind the Bulldog zone. Going to be played in behind there by Jacobs, fighting hard with two Mustangs. Puck comes out. Where is it? Can't find it. Puck along the Zamboni's door. Crestwood going to keep it deep. Play all the way around the far zone. No way. Klimo says he touched it. We're less than a minute, DJ. 54 seconds. 5-1, Meadville. We're under a minute. Third period. I've got goose pimples.
Yeah, it's getting a little exciting, that's for sure.
I'll tell you what.
Everybody's up on the bench over here.
Last time I was this excited, I got an A in school. Pass in front, where's it going to go? If can't get it there by Greg. Puck's coming out the other way. 28 seconds on a running clock. Going to try to keep it deep. Wheel and deal. Crestwood going to take a shot. Oh, nice save there by Kaufman. Puck going to come back the other way. Patassi, the people are banging on the board. We got noise. We got glass. We got people pounding. My coffee spilled periods ago. Here we go. 8 seconds, less than 10. Count them down. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. There it is.
There it is.
History in the making. In the making.
1,000 wins for Chief.
1,000 wins. 1,000 wins for Coach Jamie Plunkett. Ladies and gentlemen, I'll tell you what, a milestone has been made. Look at them mobbing them down on the bench. Everybody's all over Chief. What a great way to end it.
Yeah, way to end it is right.
What a good win. Now, that was a convincing win for sure. There we go. Everybody's giving Chief. All the players are hugging coaches. You can see it here. There's Murray on the ice. There goes Millen with his tassel, with his toque looking good. He'll be able to play tomorrow, but he's got... But anyways, we missed him. He's a good player, but in any case, he was here for the celebration. And we got some festivities here. Looks like Gene Wazinski's going to have the microphone. Not sure what he's going to be doing here. We got the basic traditional handshake. I wouldn't expect anything, no fancy dance stuff here. I would think this is going to be pretty straightforward.
Yeah, what a historic night here, that's for sure. Great to get Chief the 1,000 wins here, like you said, in a convincing fashion, 5-1.
And someone that he knows these coaches really well. I mean, he's been coaching against these guys. This is, you know, his local establishment. So I think it's a good thing. You know, it's, you know, again, it would have been nice to get it Monday, but somehow this is sort of a special win, I think.
Yeah, playing against his own his own native country.
That's it.
Out.
More handshakes here. Gene Wazinski's trying to get somebody to... he's waving at somebody. Chief's head towards center ice. We got Crestwood on their blue line, respectively. We got the Bulldogs on their blue line. Helmets are off. I'm not sure what's going to happen here. We're going to stay with it for a little longer. Yeah, we'll just see what's going on. See if we can hear what's going on with the public address.
The first down is a player of the game. Our player of the game today is Coach Jamie Plunkett.
Player of the game. In case you couldn't hear that, it's player of the game.
Yeah, this guy, that was a no-brainer.
Milestone. Crestwood boys can take a couple of these hits.
First victory in 1986. He's been a big number of marks.
Thank you for everything, can't do it alone type thing. And so I think that's the end of the on-ice facilities. Crestwood, I'll tell you what, they've been very very hospitable. They've been standing on a blue line at attention. I mean, they did a nice, you know, not being disruptive in any means. So my hat's off to the Crestwood Mustangs, not only for coming up, but actually playing the game tonight. Cody Pasilla just handed the game puck to Chief. In Millen's absence, assistant captain Cody Pasilla hand him the puck. But in any case, there's a picture going to be taken here now. We've got everybody kind of crowding around Coach Plunkett. Probably a picture, you know, DJ at some point will hang, and when he gets to be my age, maybe throw it in a closet. But for a while, they're going to cherish this time, right?
Absolutely, yeah. Again, it's, you know, 8 state championships, 1,000 wins. The program wouldn't be here without him.
Well, DJ, I think you were involved in Win 300, weren't you?
It was definitely one of the hundreds. I think it actually was a little later than that. I think it was closer to 600. It would have been, I think it would have been, against Plum. We will beat them 4-1 here in this building.
Yeah.
First round of the playoffs that we participated in 2003 on a wear out to state championship.
Yeah, so there you go. So you know how it felt to have a 600 win banner. I can't imagine what it is to be on the part of the side that, you know, won the 1,000 banner.
Boy, yeah, 400 wins later.
Yeah, really. Well, it looks like we're going to get a group photo here. This is like international hockey at its best here. So I guess we can crowd everybody in. Nice gesture here. I think, you know, in a way, it's kind of a nice way that way to go out. I mean, it's I guess some people would like to have beaten somebody else, or somebody would might have said something to somebody, you know, had another team. But I think it ended the way it should have.
Yeah, it was a good, clean game to be on, too. No animosity between the players, and obviously ended the way that all the Meadville fans wanted it. Certainly.
Right, right. Well, I'll tell you what. I think what we'll do is we'll take a moment here. Let's just step away here a minute, and I think what we'll do is try to get in a locker room. I think Chief's gonna probably want to say something to the boys, have some time with them, and then maybe we can sort of get in and see if we can get some comments. So let's just take a break here now and see if we can't get down and get some comments from Coach Plunkett. Again, the final 5-1 in favor of Meadville. The good guys win. And so we'll be back, hopefully, getting some comments from Coach Plunkett. Again, Dan Craven from DJ Craven for now from the George S. DeArm Ice Arena. Good. Yeah, Dan Craven back with DJ Craven here in the locker room with Captain Jeff Millen. Jeff, we were watching you. We were definitely here Monday, did the game as well. And I know that, you know, the boys were out there without you, hopping around doing their thing. But how did it feel looking at it from the penalty box?
Well, last Monday I was kind of used to it, looking out from the penalty box. But so I kind of was full nature to go in there. But it was fun watching them, but it also kind of sucked that I couldn't help them, but it was fun watching them.
I just one quick thing. You know, it's one thing to play for the Bulldogs. It's another thing to play for the Bulldogs and be a captain of the Bulldogs. You know, you're in a small group of a lot of, you know, excellent hockey players. But there's one thing you have on your resume. There's only a few people out there that are captains at different levels. We had the 300 win. We had a 400 win. But you can honestly say now you were the captain of the squad that won the 1,000th win, the record breaker. How does that make you feel?
It makes me feel good. I'm proud of myself. I'm proud of this team. We all work hard. And I'm proud to know Chief. He's an awesome guy and an awesome coach.
DJ, got anything?
Yeah, I think the only thing I was going to ask is that obviously come off of a tough win on Monday. You know, you have a better advantage there against Burrow. We all know that. And I guess my one question is, what was Chief's message this week? I know you only had one practice between then and then and this Friday here, but what was the message this week to kind of be able to put these guys away?
He really just focused on us, you know, just relaxing, playing the game. I think a lot of pressure and a lot of build up was for the Monday game. No excuses, but he really just wanted us to play hockey and play our game and just forget about the 1,000th win. And when it comes, we'll celebrate it then.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, okay, thanks. This is Dan Craven, DJ Craven, Jeff Millen. We'll come back with a couple more interviews, try to get a couple more players. Definitely going to get a hold of Chief, maybe some of the coaching staff. So we'll be right back with you. This is Dan Craven with DJ Craven with Coach Scott Phillips. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah, I was just saying, you know, there's some people have all these different twists on things, and you have a little bit of different twist of the fact that now that you weren't even you know, a coach, which was a part of the wins, but you're also a player as a part of the wins. How does that feel to put that on your resume?
Well, as I've said before, as a player, you don't I don't think you truly appreciated it at the time. That was a long time ago for me, obviously. I think I was in the maybe the 100 to 200 win range. You know, as a coach, you're not checking off the victories. And then, you know, when they said this year he's going to get 1,000, you start processing that, and it's impressive.
Have you really kind of processed it enough? I mean, is it kind of still surreal at this point? I mean, obviously, you know, we were kind of the similar. I mean, obviously, you had a better career than I did, but from playing for him, and then obviously all the so many years in coaching for him, has it really sunk in? And really, what 1,000 wins and how you can achieve that? I mean, that's impressive.
I don't think it has. You know, I coach my son's U10 team, and to me, 1 year, that's been stressful enough. So doing it for 31 years, I think, you know, and when it's all said and done and people look back on it, it's a huge accomplishment. It's a huge accomplishment.
Absolutely.
Yeah, you know, like everybody said a million times, it takes more than one thing. It takes, you know, the family, it takes coaches and so on and so forth. But, I mean, you guys, both of you guys were a part of all this, right? You know, it just doesn't happen with all that. It's just kind of neat to see people come and go and that kind of stuff. But, obviously this next step is looking to get through the league and playoff.
Yeah, you know, the team's goal this year, besides getting Jamie 1,000 wins, is to go undefeated in the league, and we have a tie, but we still haven't been beat. So I know that, you know, that goal's still alive and well. And then, you know, the playoffs is a new season. Anything can happen. So, obviously, we want to win the league. And I think really with this group of kids, anything short of that would be a disappointment. So we got a month left here, roughly, hopefully we peak at the right time and we can, get these kids a league championship.
Yeah, you know, it's a big milestone, obviously, that we just hit here and kind of talking about going forward. I mean, they had a little bit of adversity there on Monday. I mean, it's a game that, you know, that they know they should have won, get down 2-0 right away. Can you kind of talk about how that can actually help a team, you know, later on in the playoffs and how that actually might, you know, that tie might come in your back pocket, actually in your favor later on?
Yeah, no doubt. I think the reality is that team was who we may face in the first round, potentially. And, you know, when you're winning a lot of games by a lot of goals, you start feeling pretty good about yourself and probably too good. And I think that definitely brought these kids back to reality a little bit within our league. And I think they realized that they have to show up and be ready to go. And hopefully they won't take it for granted, you know, and they'll be ready when next time we see them.
Absolutely. All right, well, thanks, Coach. Appreciate it. Good
Thank
luck.
You.
We'll be seeing
Appreciate
you again. Thank you. All right, this is Dan Craven with DJ Craven. Now we've got Chief. Congratulations.
Thank you, Dan. Appreciate it.
That's a huge win. We were just, DJ and I were talking. We were trying to figure out other sports, how long it would take somebody to get 1,000 wins in some other sports, and it's like physically impossible.
Well, you schedule 50 games or thereabouts every year and stick around as long as I have, you're going to win or lose 1,000 games, maybe. So.
Well, DJ, you got a chance to get a shot at coach here.
Well, I guess the one question I would ask is, I mean, obviously you've been a part of some great teams. You've been a part of some great things. I know that your common phrase is like picking your kid. So don't give me that line. But how does this one rank up to all the other achievements you've had over your career?
You know, it hasn't sunk in yet. I think it will at some point. But this group is, We only graduated two kids off last year's team, Trevor Johnson, Sam Kinniston. So we brought back essentially the same group. We added a couple players. And we were disappointed that we had our season ended in the second round. So I think this group has been focused from day one. And the nice thing about starting with the same group is you really can just pick up where you left off at the year ago. So we were much further along at the beginning of this season than we've been in previous years. So, we've had more success this year than we've had in recent years. So it's been fun again. You know, we've had some success at some tournaments. We didn't win them, but we gave good count of ourselves. I've been telling some of the former players that I think this blue line as a group collectively, I think maybe as good a group I've ever had. This is the third year they're together, the three juniors and Barrett, a senior. And then last year our leading scorer was a freshman, Nick Frantz, and he's hit the 50-goal mark today. Jeff Millen, Cody Pasilla. So we knew we were going to be able to improve on our offense this year. So We had a feeling that if we worked hard and played the game the right way, that we had a chance to improve on what we've done the last couple of years. And coaches, same group of coaches last few years. So it's been a lot of fun. We keep pushing these kids. We still think we can go to another level, and trying to draw that out of them. And hopefully getting close to the end of the regular season, and we can go a little step or two further than we have the last couple of years. So.
Absolutely.
Yeah, so team kind of gelled together. DJ and I were talking beforehand, and we knew that Jeff Millen was going to be out because of suspension, and of course,
you know, you got to mix the lines up a little bit, and that's coaching. So, I mean, it was, you know, you wonder how somebody's going to respond to that. So it seems like the kids came out and responded pretty well.
I think they were a little bit disappointed after the other night. I think that was, you know, kind of out of character for 10-minute misconducts. You know, just I think they were just trying too hard and maybe a little nervous, and we tried to address it on Wednesday after practice that, you know, if that's how you're going to respond in the playoffs, then we're not going to be very successful. You just have to go out and play the game. But and, you know, you touched on Millen being out of the lineup, and obviously Jeff would love to have been a part of that. He's our team captain. But what we have this year for the first time in several years is more depth. So if, a couple of years ago, if we lose a guy of Jeff Millen's ability, we're probably really in big trouble. But now we've got a little more depth, and we don't have to rely on one or two kids like we have had to do in the last few years. And, you know, Chase Leach had a nice game today, and Nick Franz had a couple goals. So we're able to get contributions from more than just one or two kids. But I think the biggest thing different tonight, I think they were a little more relaxed, and they just went out and, you know, I just said, hey, you know, just play the game and have fun with it. And I thought that we were better at that.
Yeah, I think... Yeah, just closing, DJ, you might have something to say, but I know, you know, and, you know, being a part of the Bulldog thing just for the little short span I was, it's just it's a good thing, you know. It's just, I'm just happy for you. It's a lot of hard work, you know. It's one thing to say, you know, you see banners up there, 300, 500 wins, people come and go, but there's a lot of blood, sweat, and tears that goes in behind that, and so, you know, I definitely appreciated all the hard work that you put through with your coaches and so on and so forth. You went through a lot of coaches, didn't you, there?
Yeah, they tell me it was me, you know, hard to work with. So, you know, you're a hockey dad. You know what it takes to you know, it's a six-month season. There's big sacrifices that, you know, you've got a daughter and, you know, you're away, you know, traveling. It's getting up, you know, early hours, getting home late, you know, and it's a lot of sacrifice. And I think that's one of the reasons the program has been as close as it has over the years, because you spend so much time with your child and families, going to away games, carpooling and hotels and things like that. And I think just out of necessity, you have to get along with these people. So, it's been a great experience for my family and I all along.
I was going to say, you know, I know they've been very supportive and so on and so forth. But DJ, any closing comments?
Yeah, I mean, I guess I'd just like to say from the whole Bulldog community of being one of those former alumni, I mean, obviously we really appreciate everything you've done here, and we thank you for everything that you've taught us, you know, all through the years. I can speak for everybody in saying we thank you. Thanks again.
And thank you, and it's a mutual. There's no way you can do this alone. You know, it's the players first, it's the coaches, the parents, and you're right. We have the community is behind not just hockey. They get behind football and basketball. Those two teams have had great seasons so this year, and they've done it with baseball and soccer. So, you know, that's one of the things that, you know, makes you want to keep coming back year after year, because you have such great support here. So,
well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Hey, hopefully you're standing here 500 more wins away. Huh?
Well, 1,500? Well, talk about the memo tag.
All right. Thanks again. This is Dan Crane with DJ from the locker room with Coach Plunkett. Congratulations to Jamie Plunkett and the whole Bulldog Nation. It's a great win. It's great for the society. It's just great for everybody. But hopefully we'll be back to see you in the playoffs. Again, Dan Crane with DJ from the 3rd District of the Armin Ice Arena. Catch you later.